This is my shed, and as you can see, it's under a large tree. So it gets loads of bits on the felt roof. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a metal roof on it. I've got these steel panels, galvanized, and they're painted green, which is the color I'm going to do. And that's a ridge piece to go in the top. This is the inside of the shed. You can see I've got these rafters, which I'm going to use to screw into with the panels. These are what I'm going to be using to put the panels in place. These self-tapping screws, which have got a hex head, and they've got a washer with a gasket, which you tighten down, not too tight. It just forms a waterproof seal. They're 45mm long. I'm just marking with chalk where the rafters are at the moment. I'm just going to finish this up. And what I've noticed is there's quite big gaps in between. So what I might have to do is put some additional bits of wood underneath where the screws are going to go in, because they're quite long screws and they'll go straight through the ceiling. I've placed the first sheet using the small edge of the panel, which is level with the end of the roof, and I'm going to put a flashing that I showed you earlier over that. And what I've done at the front for the lip is I've got a piece of wood 4.5cm wide, and I'm just using that block to measure the overhang. Double check with my bit of wood. That's the first panel, first bottom screws in place. Keep it there. I can start working off this panel now. I'm putting the rest of the screws in. I've just drilled 4 holes, so we've got that one. So there's going to be 4 rows of screws that are going to go straight across in line for each panel. Now that the first panel's in place, I'm going to put some of the other panels over, because I've got quite a bit of overlap, and it might save me cutting it if I can fit it, overlapping a couple of the risers. We'll see how we get on. Okay, how I'm going to work it is 1 overlap, 2 overlaps in the middle, and then 1 overlap again, and I'll have a bit spare. Okay, I've quickly found that rather than drilling, if you just tap the top of the screw with a hammer, you get enough to start the hole off, and then you can drive it in with the driver. A Okay, you can see four lines of screws on this front side, and now I'm about to put the last one in. Lovely. Back. Absolutely fine. It's the start of the first panel. This is the last screw of all the actual panels. And you can see how I do the edges. Okay, I've left a bit of an overhang there, and now I'm going to measure how much I need to cut minimum off the other piece. This is a 70 centimeter piece that I've cut off another 3 meter length, which I had. I could only buy them in 3 meter lengths for the center flashing. So what I've done is, with the other 2.3 meters, I've cut a piece 1.44 meters off to do the two side bits at the front, to make some flashing for that. And what I've actually done, there's my 1.44 centimeter bit, and I've cut it down the middle along the apex of the ridge, if you like, to give me two pieces. And I'm going to bend these into 90 degree angles and use them to make the flashing down the sides. This is what I used to carry out the cuts. I tried using tin snips, but it was a nightmare. So now I've used a hacksaw blade on a Makita jigsaw, and it did the job absolutely fine. Okay, these pieces are 19 centimeters. So that's what I got to play with. I've got 19 centimeter strip. This is 12 centimeters, so I'm going to have 7 centimeters tucked underneath here, and then a 12 centimeter overhang covering the wood. I've drawn a line at 12 centimeters now, and I butt that up, put a big strong piece of wood on it, which I'll clamp, and then I'll bend it over. So, okay, I've clamped up using a big bit of wood on this piece of metal. I'm gonna now, it's along the 12mm line, I'm now gonna bend this bit forward, see if I can make a nice clean fold. put the flash in level with the piece of wood. Now I'm going to go up to the apex and work out where I need my line. So there's the finished cut. I'm using these 5.5mm by 25mm screws for the top flashings and the side flashings. Finished this one side panel. As you can see, I've put these 25mm screws in, screwed it down. What I actually had to do, where the flashing goes underneath, I had to lift this one panel up so that I could put a screw there and a screw down the bottom just to keep them down. And then I put those screws back. So this side, I've got to do these, but as you can see, that's sticking up, so I'm going to put a screw under there and one at the bottom as well. Close up, looking good. Looking at this apex, when the actual flashing's on, I think I need to bring it down and overlap. So I'm looking at about 6mm. 7 to be sure. So I'm cutting 7mm. I've marked 2 7mm lines and I'm going to bend this up on each side. Okay, I'm going to bend this now by pushing down on it. I'm going to bend the second side now. That's the piece in place. I think I'll actually leave that overlap and put a screw in. It's a bit more watertight than cutting it down the middle. Okay, I've put 3 bolts in. And now I'm going to bolt the top section. And that's looking good. Shed's virtually complete. Last screw. And it's now finished. Happy days. There we go, the finished article. Quite pleased with that.